So we just heard a couple of hours ago that our teacher, Zen Master Shinzan, had died. And here we are a couple of hours later, starting a session of 49 days. And it's all been very quick and very sudden. Thank you particularly to Mark, who's been able to set things up very, very fast. It's a shock. There's a lot of emotion always in these times and these situations. One perspective on this we find in the Lotus Sutra, perhaps the most central sutra in the Buddhism of Japan and China, Korea, the Buddhism of East Asia. Chapter 16, which you may want to study, you may want to read at this time, discusses this situation of dying. And the Buddha tells a story. He tells a story about a doctor who's called away to a patient some distance away from the house, from his home. And he's away for some time, at least several days. And while he's away, the children break into his medicine stores and get absolutely out of their minds on his medicines. So he comes back, finding the house in chaos and his kids three sheets to the wind, intoxicated, inebriated. He tries to get them to sober up. He has various kinds of antidotes he can offer them and so on, but they're so preoccupied in their intoxication, they don't even listen to him. So he gives up for a moment. He goes away. He gets an assistant, perhaps it's a friend, perhaps it's somebody he hires, to rush into the house and say to the kids, to shout, "Your father has died." And the shock of this causes the children to sober up, come outside, where they find their father waiting. And they're able to then take the antidotes for the intoxicants in their bodies. So the shock, the surprise, the grief, the pain that we feel can help to sober us up, help us to wake up to the reality of things. And then in this teaching, the Buddha goes on to say that his true life is essentially beginningless and endless, is immeasurable. He seems to die, to disappear, to go away from us. And on one level, of course, this is true. Person after person in your life is going to die and disappear and go away from you. But this true life, what in Zen they sometimes call the life of Buddha, referencing this chapter 16 of the Lotus Sutra, this true life is beginningless and endless. As the scientists tell us, energy can neither be created nor destroyed. We have 49 days. It's quite long. But it could be 49 years. It could be 49 eons. It could be 49 light years. It's a time in which something can happen. Us Zen people typically don't just want to hear these teachings. We want to know them for ourselves, in our blood and bones, our direct experience. We want to know this beginningless, endless life of Buddha. As we have this time to sit together, and even when perhaps you're doing other things, you can know that this is going on. Perhaps you can connect with this beginningless, endless life of Zen Master Shinzan, which is the beginningless, endless quality of your life. And the same for Master Hakuin, Master Rinzai, all the ancestors. If we can use this time to immerse in this beginningless, endless life, we can know Zen Master Shinzan. We can meet Zen Master Shinzan. And we can continue his work in the world. We can continue his mission. When he began to teach at Gyokuruji, our home temple, he put up a sign at the gate. It's still there. Satori place, or enlightenment place, for young and old people. His mission was to make this available to everybody. For young people, for old people, for all of us. As we connect with this beginningless, endless life, we naturally help others do the same thing, because it's very contagious. So we have this time. Thank you so much for responding instantly. The schedule is there. No one person is going to be sitting for the whole of the 49 days for every single period. But many of us will be here as much as we can. And the aim is to keep the schedule going regardless, so that at least one person at any one time is keeping the schedule going. So this beginningless, endless thread is maintained. We manifest the life of Buddha through our sitting together. Thank you for joining in this. So of course you're very welcome to keep sitting as you wish through the night, as much or as little as you wish. But our formal schedule will pick up again tomorrow morning. So thank you again.